In this video, I want to demonstrate how to add closed captioning or subtitles to your YouTube videos. It's a simple process, but it makes your video more accessible by not only people, but also by search engines trying to find the content that is found within your videos. To add closed captioning, log in to your YouTube account, go to your video manager, and choose a video. In this case, I have just uploaded this video. You can either click on the down arrow next to edit, and choose subtitle/CC, or you can click on edit and then click on subtitles/CC. YouTube begins by asking you what language your video is recorded in. If that's the default language, you can go ahead and set that as your default language. Oftentimes there is an automatic transcribed text of this video. Right now it's showing it as published. If I select on this, it will show me the text that YouTube has transcribed. If you have a nice clear audio signal coming from a nice microphone, oftentimes YouTube is pretty accurate. But if there's a lot of background noise or wind, or your microphone isn't the greatest, you're going to have some errors that need to be fixed. I can go ahead and go through and look at the text. On the left-hand side, you can see the text. On the right-hand side, you can see the video, and you can see the text underneath the video with the timings set up. If I want to edit and make this correct, which I do, I'm going to go ahead and click on the Edit button. This will now allow me to go through and make some changes. I can simply press play.
Now that you've been able to do a few student broadcasts,
and I can see the timing as it goes. If the timing is off, I can actually select below and click on the blue box and slide it right to where I want the timing to appear. I can go back with my playhead.
Now that you've been able to do a few student broadcasts, it's time to up your game. This week, you're...
In this case, it has up your game on two different sections. I want that to be together. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this out from that section, and I'm going to paste it in this section. You could also go through and type it in. If I wanted to adjust the time here, I could do that as well. I can simply click in the text area, change it, then I go to the next one and change it as well.
Now that you've been able to do a few student broadcasts, it's time to up your game. This week, your assignment is to replace a green screen behind the talent with a virtual set.
As you can see, the auto transcribe is fairly accurate. Once you have gone through and checked to make sure that the text is correct, you can simply click on Publish Edits, and it will save the edits that you have as English rather than English Automatic. Notice how both of these are set up. This will allow the viewer to choose which version they want to watch. I'm going to go ahead and select the automatic closed captioning, and now I'm going to unpublish the automatic. So when I go back to my subtitles menu, notice how now it has it saved as a draft, but it has my published version. This ensures that the viewer gets the correct version of your closed captioning. I can now select the URL and test it out.
Now that you've been able to do a few student broadcasts, it's time to up your game. This week, your assignment is to replace
if I click on closed captioning subtitles
with a virtual,
you can see that I have this here. I can turn that on or turn it off. Once again, this is a great way to not only have your video more accessible to users, but to search engines that are crawling the text trying to find more information about your video. If you have enjoyed this video, please like the video, share it with others, or leave a comment below. If you'd like to get more technology tips, please subscribe to the Sterling Teaches YouTube channel. Thank you and have a great day!